Now we start using the smart dilutor. First of all, one should know that smart dilutor comes with a CD-ROM from which you get the user guide, smart dilutor W. One should know that there are two functions for this diluter. One is the dilution, so for that you need a dilution factor, and the other one is dispensing. In the case of dispensing, you have a sample, you have targeted a final weight when you mix your sample with a diluent. That is dispensing. So that's why also you have two bottles, so you can use one for each of the function according to the type of work you want. Now, if you connect the machine to the electrical socket, you start it indeed by using a button in the back here, this button, and you press the button that is protected by a plastic cover, and then you get the starting screen here, on which you have three main lines. The first one is dealing with the bag. You have the drawing of the bag here. First I will put zero, and then I will put inside the bag that will receive my sample by fixing on the top using this tapes, and keep the bag open at the top while the bottom is supported by the bottom of the plastic support. And this is open like that. Then I will put in a few minutes my sample. But I have to make the tear first. The tear is done when you have till the machine that is empty. Let's start again. This is zero, so there is nothing on it. Now, by tearing, I have to weight first the plastic bag. So if I put the plastic bag, you can see the screen is changing. The screen is changing, giving the weight of the plastic bag here. Then I fix the plastic bag properly here, keeping its mouth opened, and the bottom at the bottom of this the plastic support. And then I make the tear so that the weight of the plastic bag will be incorporated and start to zero. Now, you see that the sample icon that is here, that is a shrink, is the one used for dilution method. And I can change the dilution method if I take the basic menu here, from here, and I enter the symbol of the pump, that is the type of ring here. You enter there, and you have two options for the pump numbers you have selected. You can select either dispensing or dilution. The shrink is where you have the dilution. You have this tube where you have dispensing. In my case, I have selected for pump one the dilution. And then you enter a menu, submenu here, where still you can change the pump number. You have two pumps only. And the dilution factor also, by just pushing these small triangles, you can move in between the fields. And the dilution factor you can change here by making press on the small V, and then I have chosen here a dilution factor of 1/10. That's okay. And also, if it's okay, then I press the V, and I'm out. I move to the following field, and then I can choose the interval of max, minimum, and maximum weight of my sample to have more precision, or I move in the next field by pushing the button down, or directly by pushing this round circle where you have the keyboard and where you can give an ID, a number or a name to your sample. If I push here, the keyboard is crossed. It means that the machine itself will provide the ID to your sample. But if I push again, it's uncrossed. Then if I press the turn back button here, it will show me a keyboard from which I can enter the number or the ID of my sample by just pushing this button here. Okay, if I'm done, then I go back here, and then I'm again in the first screen with a tiered plastic bag. Now I will put inside, maybe for the example of dilution here, I will just put, let's assume this is my sample, I'll put something like 20 milligram. I look at the screen here and it's moving. When I put my sample inside, okay, 20, 36, I'll put maybe 40 of my sample, 40. Okay, it's 39.5, and that is 40, that's okay. Then, since I have a dilution factor of 1 over 10, normally it will add from pump number 1 that is selected here. This is the pump number 1, is this bottle indeed, this one, where I have my diluent, and then it will mix with my sample according to the dilution factor. I guess if you have one volume here or one weight, it will add 9 weight. Then we should have something around 400 grams in this case. To trigger, to start the dilution process, I just pull forward the frame, the metallic frame, and then at a certain moment it start pumping and putting water inside. And look at the screen, it's changing, 200 now, 240, 50, 60, etc. And it should stop somewhere around 400 grams. Yeah, that's it. Then you get this beep showing that you have made your dilution according to the factor 1 out of 10. And that's all for dilution. The next, we will show how the dispensing is done.